NASA is about to attempt something they've never done before.
This is the first time we've had an interplanetary launch from Vandenberg Air Force Base in California. The cool thing about this launch is that we've got such a capable rocket, the Atlas V, we don't have to launch from Florida.
So InSight is going to be the first time that we've had a spacecraft leave Earth's orbit launching from California. We've actually done studies for it even up to decades ago, but it just comes down to whether or not the mission had extra propellant left over and whether there was an operational reason to switch from an East Coast launch to a West Coast. This is just the first time all of it came together.
What we're going to do is we're going to unload the spacecraft really, really carefully, and then we're going to drive it a couple of miles to the Astrotech facility where they have a clean room all set up for us. We've got about 2 months here. All we got to do is clean it up, test it out, put the fuel in the tanks, and bolt it on the rocket, and off we go to Mars.
It's unlike other missions that we've done to Mars. We have a number of orbiters, a number of landers that we've successfully explored this amazing planet. But this actually is the first mission where we're really looking on the inside, the inner space of Mars.
Sending a science mission to Mars is not easy. Landing a probe on the surface is even harder. InSight's compact and incredibly efficient design makes sure it gets there and touches down safely.
So the crew stage itself is the critical component that actually gets us to Mars. There's an aeroshell that absorbs the heat as we re-enter the atmosphere. That aeroshell enables us to go through the atmosphere of Mars successfully without getting the inside, the lander itself, too hot. We deploy a parachute. That parachute does two things. It really ensures the stability of the aeroshell as it's starting to get closer to the surface. It also slows down the spacecraft further until finally we drop out of the combination back shell and parachute, and then we do a propulsive descent down to the surface.
Planetary protection is what we do to responsibly explore other planets and moons in our solar system. In order to do that, we need to make sure that we send a clean spacecraft there. So we would hate to get to another planet or moon and think we discovered life, but it was actually something that we brought with us. So we collect our samples on InSight, any part of InSight that's going to land on the surface of Mars. We bring it back to our lab and we process it using a NASA procedure. If we run into a situation where we take a sample and it comes back as having a higher number of bacteria than what we want, then we make sure that engineers go back and clean those surfaces, with the whole idea that eventually with missions that have life detection capabilities, we don't want to cloud our ability to potentially find life on another planet or moons.
The work being done now here at Astrotech is critical to ensure InSight's safe arrival and landing on the red planet. It has to be perfect before it leaves Earth on the 6-month journey to Mars. As soon as the spacecraft is fueled and tested, InSight will be encapsulated and sent to the launch pad to be mated with the Atlas V, patiently awaiting T0.